안녕하세요, 여러분. 오늘은 제가 2021년에는 이분처럼 살아야겠다 하는 분의 인터뷰를 들고 왔는데요. 이분은 어떤 분이냐면 제가 현재 일하고 있는 카페에서 같이 일을 하고 계시는 한국인 분이에요. 근데 지금까지 제 채널에서는 보통 워홀러분들에 대한 인터뷰를 많이 했는데 이분은 현재 뉴질랜드로 이민을 오신 분입니다. 그렇게 오래 되진 않으셨는데 일단 이분에 대한 소개는 좀 이따 인터뷰에서 더 자세히 알아보도록 하고 제가 이분을 인터뷰를 하게 된 계기를 먼저 말씀을 드릴게요. 제가 지금 뉴질랜드에 살고 있는지 한 2년 반 정도를 향해서 달려가고 있는데요. 벌써 그렇게 됐네요. 근데 제가 지금까지 뉴질랜드에 살면서 여러 가지 이유로 인해서 한국인하고 같이 일하는 걸 꺼렸어요. 뭐 저도 한국인인데 한국인을 싫어해서 그런 건 아니고요. 여러 가지 이유가 있었습니다. 그 여러 가지 이유 중에 한 가지를 말씀을 드리자면 뉴질랜드에 오신 지 오래 되신 이민자분들하고 같이 일을 하게 되면 뭐 안 그런 분들도 정말 많습니다만 보통 약간 나이대가 있으시고 옛날 한국에서 생각하던 사고방식을 여기에 가져오셔서 현재 제 나이 또래 한국에서 살고 있는 사람들과는 약간 사고방식이 달라서 같이 일하는데 어려움을 겪을 때가 많았어요. 그래서 그런 일을 뉴질랜드에 오자마자 몇 번 겪어서 최대한 한국인하고 일을 하는 건 피해야겠다 생각을 했습니다. 그래서 제가 한국인과 같이 일하는 걸 좀 피하고 싶어서 대부분 제가 일했던 곳들은 여기 현지 뉴질랜드 현지 잡입니다. 근데 제가 지금 일하고 있는 카페에 처음 일을 시작하게 됐는데 한국인 분이 계신 거예요. 그래서 속으로 아 제발 저 한국인 분하고 같이 일 안 했으면 좋겠다. 사실 처음엔 그런 마음을 먹었습니다. 왜냐하면 뭔가 예상이 되더라고요. 아 또 그런 분이면 어떡하지 하는. 근데 이분은 정말 제 예상을 뛰어넘을 정도로 너무 존경스러운 분이셔서 제가 인터뷰를 요청을 드렸어요. 이분은 처음 같이 일하는 그날부터 다른 같이 일하는 친구들이 영어를 사용하는 사람들이니까 저희도 같이 영어로 얘기를 했어요. 누가 먼저 우리 영어로 얘기하자 라고 합의를 본 것도 아닌데 그냥 자연스럽게 서로 영어로 얘기를 했고요. 그 전부터 시작을 해서 저랑 뭔가 비슷한 생각을 가지고 있다는 그런 확신이 조금씩 들더라고요. 그래서 같이 일하면서 여러 얘기를 나눠본 결과 이거는 무슨 노래가 여기서 끝나요? 그래서 제가 이분과 같이 일을 하면서 여러 얘기를 나눠본 결과 아, 이 얘기는 정말 나만 듣기 너무 아깝다. 제 구독자분들 뿐만 아니라 뭔가 이민을 생각하고 계시는 분들 워홀 유학을 생각하고 계시는 분들한테 모두 귀감이 될 만한 정말 멋진 분이다 라는 생각이 들어서 인터뷰 요청을 드렸습니다. 제가 이 인터뷰를 제작하기 전에 다른 이민자들에 대한 인터뷰가 있나 하고 유튜브를 좀 검색을 해봤어요. 근데 뭐 인터뷰들이 몇 개 있긴 한데 사실 잘 귀에 안 들어오더라고요. 집중력도 떨어지고. 그래서 제가 오늘 인터뷰 영상에서는 좀 더 영상에 대한 흥미와 집중도도 높이고 또 다른 인터뷰 영상과는 좀 색다른 점을 강조하기 위해서 이분이 비록 한국인이지만 저도 한국인이지만 서로 영어로 인터뷰를 진행을 해봤습니다. 물론 저나 그분이나 영어를 유창하게 하는 영어 사용자가 아니라서 중간중간 틀린 부분이 굉장히 많겠지만 제가 자막을 달아드릴 테니까 재미있게 감상해 주셨으면 좋겠습니다. 서론이 길었는데 그럼 이제 그분을 직접 만나러 가보도록 하겠습니다. Let's go! Hi, could you introduce yourself to my subscribers, please?
Hi, I'm Logan. I work at Postal Service Cafe with Lily, and I've lived in New Zealand for 6 years, and have worked my way up from McDonald's cashier to a successful cafe manager in the suburb of Auckland, Gray Lynn. And I have a beautiful wife and 2 daughters.
Okay, 6 years. Oh, then it's not too long. So have you lived in other countries before?
Yes, I lived in Toronto once when I was younger. I studied a year at the language school and I got an offer from Bank of Montreal for the internship. But I gave up because my English was not so good at the time.
Okay, what was the position of Bank of Montreal?
I was assisting the financial asset management.
Oh, that's really interesting.
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Oh.
So basically, what I've done was like doing some research and then, you know, collecting the document. But the thing is like, it was really hard for me to deeply involve because of the communication problem. To be honest with you, at that time, I was not really passionate and, you know, a little bit lack of motivation. That's why I didn't really did my best.
What did you study when you were in Korea?
You mean my major in uni?
Yeah.
I majored economics.
Ah, and that's why you got offered that kind of thing.
Yeah, yeah. And also one of the reason is I wanted to make part of my, what do you say, spec? I can write it down on my CV. I finished my internship overseas. That looks really good for me, so that's why.
Yeah, actually, we are working together, right? Yeah, so when I first saw you, I was really inspired by you making jokes and having conversation with a lot of local customers, you know? Even with no hesitation.
Yeah.
Also, it seems like that you have kind of connections with them, which Korean people never do between customers and staff.
Yeah.
Because it's a kind of cultural thing, and in my opinion, most Korean immigrants are really scared of talking to local English speakers, you know?
Yeah.
How do you talk to Kiwis in English so well? Were you originally an outgoing person, or has your personality changed after moving to New Zealand? What made you study English so hard?
Yeah, well, when I started working at Kokaku Cafe, I was the only Korean, and then everyone else was Kiwi, so they would be speaking English. So being able to connect with them was my motivation, the main motivation for me. Things really improved when one of the senior staff member encouraged me to make more small talks with customers. And at first I was hesitant, but eventually I learned people are very curious and then happy to talk and share things with me.
Oh, okay. Were they curious about you?
Yeah, they were curious about my attempt.
Attempt?
Yes.
Attempt to what?
Try to make a conversation with them.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. Seems like really natural for them. Actually, it is a lot common in New Zealand making a conversation with strangers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it feels kind of awkward in Korea, you know?
Yeah, exactly. I think Kiwis are more open, and then definitely it's a big difference between New Zealand and Korea. I highly recommend anyone who plans to live overseas, try not to be afraid, try to make friends and talk with people. I recently made a big decision. I'm having a career change. I'm going to Porirua in Wellington to begin my training to join the police force.
Police?
Yes.
That's so cool.
I am very excited to start a new career, and also I can't believe I made it from McDonald's to, you know, New Zealand police.
Yeah. So far, what was the most effective way for you to study English? Can you tell me about when you studied English the hardest? What and how did you do?
So for me, every day is the day that I'm studying hardest. And also, I can say it's now. I recommend consistency, keeping up some good habits, even if they are simple. And also, I improved a lot through watching New Zealand drama and TV shows, like Sholen Street and Police 10-7.
Okay.
Yeah.
Did Police 10-7 make you to get the police job?
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, really?
I love watching that program. Okay. It gives me the idea about how it's going on, and then I can imagine later on when I'm, you know, doing the job properly, and then all sort of like situations and kind of expressions related to the environment.
Oh, cool.
And also I read kids' books, and I try to maintain the balance between reading, listening and speaking. And the hardest thing is writing for me, because I don't do much in day-to-day life, but I'm trying to keep a journal every day.
Oh, what does it mean by keeping a journal?
Writing a diary or...
Oh,
yeah. Whenever I have a special occasion or special like...
So you write in English?
Yes, in English. Oh. Yeah. And also, for me, that's one of the good habits, and simple and really effective. Because whenever I keep a journal, I use it for my learning material with my English tutor. It really helps me to correct and learning the new expressions.
That's nice. What is the good part of reading kids' books?
Basically, you can learn simple expressions. And also, when you read kids' books, you can find out some simple but very effective way of English.
Oh, I should try. Because
You know, when you study English in Korea, we memorize all the complicated words, but we don't know how to express our thoughts or opinions in an easy way. No?
In 2019, I tried to read English books. And then my first book was Matilda. Matilda is really popular book and musical and movie as well, right? It is written by Roald Dahl, who is really famous author for kids. Basically, it was really fun. So I think if you want to make a habit, definitely you should try to find out from the easy way rather than like picking up some like really difficult books. That really worked for me. So from the book Matilda, I really expand other genres as well. What do you say, like in Korean?
자기계발서.
자기계발서, yes. Self-development book, psychology, or history. At the end of the 2019, I finished like 30 books. And then I was so proud of myself. It gave me, you know, enjoyment and also new habit reading a book. So I strongly recommend.
So is there any differences of living in New Zealand when you're not good at English and now?
Definitely, I feel like I'm a Kiwi now and active part of New Zealand. And also learning English really opened doors for me in regards to the work I can do and then friendship I can keep.
Then what are your plans studying English in the future?
So in the future, it's gonna be the same in terms of consistency and keeping up some good habits.
Writing books, writing a journal.
Yeah, that's right. Keeping the balance and just study hard.
So that was pretty much it for today. How was the interview?
Actually, I really appreciate that you gave me this interview opportunity. I feel like I really enjoyed. At the beginning, I was really nervous. But because
really?
Of...
Really? Were you nervous?
Because doing the interview is so awkward. I've never done it before, you know. But as you assured me that I don't have to worry about, so I trusted you. I really enjoyed the whole interview today. As I got inspired by watching your YouTube channel, definitely I'm sure that many subscribers would be the same.
Oh, so sweet.
So hopefully, I wish your YouTube channel will grow bigger and bigger. Thank you for having me today.
Yeah. Thanks for your time.
Yeah, no problem.
Yeah. Do you want to say anything to immigrants all over the world? Korean immigrants. Yes. Yeah, or people who are trying to immigrate to other countries from Korea.
Yeah, this part is, I think, one of the most important questions. Because before they make a big decision, they might see all the positive things, but they should consider that it's gonna be hard for them several years.
In real life.
Yeah, in real life. Same things apply to me. I struggled a lot at the beginning, but you know, after that, definitely it's worth it. You will see the positive like outcomes slowly. Don't rush, be patient.
Oh, you're like Steve Jobs.
Be consistent, right? I think that's a key word for me. Hi, subscribers. So today's interview, we put a lot of effort. It was so much fun. So if you really enjoyed the video, please subscribe and press the like button. Thank you.